Hotel's made in, huh? So where do you want to start? Home permanent or
the frozen cookie dough?
Vinnie called. Oh. I wish you had a semi-serious on-again, off-again relationship, too. You go meet Vinnie. I got work to catch up on anyway. Come on, Tess. It's been months. Wouldn't you like something to touch your lips other than chapstick?
Yes, of course I would.
So why not go out with that guy Ethan?
A blind date? I would rather epilating my entire body.
Come on, Tess, he's a doctor. How bad can it be?
Would you go out with somebody your mother wanted to fix you up with?
Well, yeah. Well, my mother never thinks I'm good enough for anyone.
Look, when I meet my dream man, it's not going to be on a blind date my mother set up. Maybe I'll meet him on a moonlit beach, or on a windswept mountaintop, or maybe in a car accident, I don't know.
It just has to be fate. Hey, if you'd waited for fate to give you a promotion, you'd still be a secretary.
All right. I will go out with him.
Mom?
Don't float. About that guy you're telling me about? You're floating, aren't you? I can hear it.
Joint.
I know, but why did I arrange to have drinks with a blind date in a place where I work?
I guess because you're lame.
Hi, Mr. Trask.
Relax, he doesn't even know you.
I feel so much better.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh, what? It's 8:02.
Oh?
Well, first he's late for the date, then he's late for the wedding, then he's working late, and then he's late with the alimony payments.
Lana, you were the one who talked me into this. I'm nervous enough already. Let's just give the guy a chance.
Fine.
Just don't leave me alone with him.
Tess McGill?
Ethan Moran?
That's right.
You like him?
See ya.
Rat.
Your mother was wrong about you. You're not just skin and bone.
Well, my mother's wrong about a lot of things.
Dr. Moron, part of your suit?
No.
Yes. We're the morons. We like a table with no view.
Right this way.
Here you are.
A table with no view. Your wedding Yosef will be with you in a moment.
We don't want a waiter named Yosef. We're morons. We want a waiter named Shem. Maybe I went too far.
Don't worry about it. We're morons.
I'm your waiter, Shem. Note, Chef Curly is cooking with mesquite this evening. Would you care to order some appetizers to hurl across the room?
All right, I will have the grilled zucchini spear.
Zucchini?
And an order for you, sir.
No, I'll just stare at her.
Certainly.
Ethan, are you okay?
Yes. It's just that my wife, well, my ex-wife, actually, zucchini was our vegetable.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have ordered it.
How could you have known?
So, you're divorced.
Separated, actually, although it's pretty final. It's been six days.
6 days? Don't you think that's a little soon to be dating?
No, it's good for me to be out with people talking. It helps me identify and confront what went wrong. Why Camille left me for a pastry chef.
It'll help you out. I won't order dessert.
Right? It's Tess. Tess McGill, right?
Mr. Trask, yes.
I'm sorry I didn't recognize you before. It took me a few minutes to scan my mental Rolodex.
That's all right. This is my boss, Mr. A.J. Trask, Dr. Ethan Moran.
Are you all right?
Zucchini.
Well, I'm embarrassed.
It's been a lovely evening. Let's do it again. Good night.
Would this be a good time to tell you about the specials?
Thank you. I'll just take the check, please.
I'll take care of it, Joker.
Blind date.
Say no more.
I don't normally go out on blind dates. Just my mother knew his aunt, and they thought I was working too hard. Not that that is a bad thing, because I like to work hard, and you deserve hardworking employees.
Let me tell you, Tess, a blind date is a lot like taking a write-off on your fourth quarter capitalization and going out with a woman you've never met before and having a lousy time. Actually, it's more like just the second part.
Well, I can't picture you on a blind date.
I once took a blind date to a dinner party at a client's house. She got falling down drunk and propositioned the client's wife. Then I had to drive her 90 miles home while she sang, A.J., A.J., Bo-Bay-J, Banana, Panna, Bo-Fay-J, B-Fi, Mo-May-J, A.J. Am I really that demanding?
Debbie! Get me somebody on the phone! Buy some buildings, sell some forests. Oh, and put some hotels on Boardwalk and Park Place. Oh, also, I want it to be 75 degrees today. Take care of it.
I'm a baritone, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like us to stay open for another hour, sir?
I had no idea it was so late. You were the only ones left.
Well, there are 35 people in the kitchen on union overtime.
Want that? Another cup of coffee? Only cost me about $300,000.
Maybe just half a cup.
No, I don't know what Tess did this weekend. And it's none of your business anyway.
Ooh, what's going on?
You think people would have something better to do all day than gossip?
Gossip? What about?
Oh, Tess had dinner with Mr. Trask, and now everyone thinks they're having an affair.
No kidding, an affair? Who's having an affair? Tess and Mr. Trask.
They just had dinner together.
So that's who's with Mr. Trask Friday night. Everyone in the mailroom's been talking about it. A lot of us thought it was Tess, Steve, but some of them said it was Sally from shipping.
Sally from shipping is sleeping with Soupy from sales.
Hi, everybody.
I don't care what anyone says, Tess. I think it was a smart move.
It was a smart move. What are you talking about?
You know Tess.
What?
You and Trask doing the wild thing? Come on, everyone knows that you had his romantic candlelit dinner with Mr. Trask.
There weren't any candles. It wasn't romantic. He didn't have any dinner.
There's a perfectly logical explanation for all of this.
Love to hear it. We all would.
I was on a blind date. Faith, whose wife had just left him, he burst into tears. Mr. Trask comes walking over. One thing leads to another. No. Bring it back. Nothing led to anything. It was just dinner. We just had dinner. That was it.
So what's his house like?
I didn't go to his house.
Hotel?
Yes. He's trying to tell you that nothing happened. What's the matter with you? You got potatoes in your ears?
All right, just tell me this. Did Mr. Trask mention my name at all?
Nothing happened.
Why? That's good enough for me.
Why does anybody believe me?
I don't know.
Can I speak to you for a teeny tiny minute?
Look, before you say anything, it is not true.
What's not true?
Nothing.
Oh, you mean that silly little rumor about you and AJ that's been wafting through the quarters?
Yeah, that one.
You didn't really expect me to believe that, did you?
Well, I was hoping you wouldn't, but I was afraid you would.
I know what you're up to. When I was first starting out, a friend of mine, I'll call her Babette, was eager to rise through the ranks. So, she decided to sleep with the boss. But he didn't want to. But then she realized it didn't matter whether she really slept with him or not, as long as people thought that she had. So, Babette started a little rumor, hoping that all of the vice presidents would run scared. But it didn't work. So you see, Tess, I hate to be the one to burst your little bubble, but you and AJ, it's just laughable, dear.
Morning, everyone. Thank you. Morning, Tess. I had a terrific time Friday night. Thanks. I haven't stayed up that late in years.
You corporate climbing
sick. Oh, my, you look terrible.
I'm not really sick. I just called in sick.
Yeah, I always look terrible when I lie. So, why are you home?
I can't go in. Everybody at work is talking about me sleeping with my boss. You don't want to hear about it.
Of course I do, dear.
Well, we didn't do it.
Well, call me when you do.
Everett.
Is Mr. Trask here?
No, why? Are you checking up on me?
No. Libby said you were sick. What's wrong?
Well, it's...
Oh, it's not one of those women's things, is it? Because I don't have any sisters, and I just as soon not know.
Relax. I'm not really sick.
I knew you weren't.
I'm just depressed by this rumor about Trask and me.
You mean you are carrying his job?
What?
Just kidding. I'm trying to cheer you up.
Thanks, but it's not working.
Okay, here's something my mother did that always made me laugh. Yeah, I used to hate that, too. Let me think.
Everett, this isn't going to work. I don't need cheering up. I need to figure out what to do. I mean, this rumor could ruin my entire career.
And the more I deny it, the more people think there's something to deny. I'm just so confused.
Tess, I'm not that good at giving advice. I really think you should talk to my friend.
Who's that? Me, Nigel. Everett.
Don't call me Everett, call me Nigel. Nigel!
This isn't the kind of thing you kid about. Okay, Nigel. I spent a long time trying to get to where I am. And I don't think it's fair that a rumor, a lie, could end it all.
Mm-hmm.
And I also don't think it's fair that it's about Mr. Trask. I mean, he took a chance on me. He gave me my start here. Now, what if this gets back to him?
Maybe you should talk to him.
I don't know. You think I should?
Well, I'll tell you what I do.
Everett, you're talking.
I think it's better to face things in life head on. You should control the events of your life rather than let them control you.
That's pretty good advice.
Wow, that was pretty insightful, wasn't it?
I'm gonna go get dressed.
Listen, my mother's really been getting on my nerves lately.
I'll talk to her.
Come in.
Mr. Trask. Oh, can I talk to you for a minute?
Come on in, Tess. I'll be right with you. I'm just finishing up here.
My newspaper will get the details. So for the record, Mr. Trask, would you like to comment on this rumor?
I'll either confirm or deny it.
What?
What can I do for you, Tess?
Mr. Trask, we're going to have to stop this rumor.
On the contrary, Tess, there's still a few key people who haven't heard it yet.
What?
Well, I want the stockholders to hear about it first.
Wait a minute. Are we talking about the same rumor?
I'm talking about the takeover rumor.
Oh, I'm talking about the we're sleeping together rumor.
Oh, that? What about it?
Well, what about it? It's not true.
You're telling me. Look, I know it's not true, but don't take it so seriously. Lighten up. It's the 10th one about me this month.
Well, it's my first. You know, nobody paid any attention to me when I was a secretary. Now they're paying all the wrong kinds of attention.
Comes with the territory.
I just wish there was some way I could convince them, but nobody will listen.
Would you like me to take care of it?
Oh, that would be so great.
Easy enough. Have a seat. You know, there's a sofa bed. Just kidding. Remember your shorthand?
Sure.
Good. Take a memo. To all employees from A.J. Trask, please be advised that as of today's date, write in today's date, I am not having an affair with Tess McGill. All employees are henceforth forbidden from suggesting, implying, or insinuating that said employee and I are in any way boinking. Et cetera, et cetera, so forth and so forth. Warmest regards, A.J. Trask. Worldwide distribution and use a good stationery.
You're telling me there's nothing I can do to stop it?
None that I've ever found.
So what do?
Wait. Big company like this, a new rumor comes along every 30 minutes. People have to talk about something. God knows they're not talking about work.
I'm just worried that people are thinking I didn't earn this job.
But you know you earned it, right?
Absolutely. Besides, I mean, it's ridiculous. You are my boss, and you're much older than I am. And what I mean is that we clearly have nothing in common. Hey, I love to bowl, and you love to...
Bowl, 210 average.
I like hot dogs.
Twice a week, mustard and sauerkraut.
I take the subway to work.
I take the helicopter. What's your point?
All I'm saying is that you're charming, and you're funny, and you're a great dinner companion.
Thank you.
But that's no reason for people to think that there's anything going on.
Absolutely not.
Right.
No more worrying, okay? We'll just put all this behind us and go on from here.
Okay. Well, I better be going. I've got some work to finish up, and you...
Oh, well, find something.
Thanks, Mr. Trask.
Anytime.
Don't work too hard. Mel Gibson's eye and Kevin Costner's butt. Kevin Costner's eye and Mel Gibson's butt. Didn't you see Lethal Weapon? Right. Okay. He must have Tom Cruise's smile.
Stallone's chest.
Oh. Too much. You know, guys who fill themselves up like that are compensating for something.
Who are we kidding? We're never going to get guys who look like this anyway.
Looks aren't that important.
Yeah, right. Tell that to your future child, Jojo the dog face boy.
Yeah. At least when that rumor about Trask and me was going around, people thought I had a boyfriend. Why is it so hard to find the right guy? All I want is someone who's funny, but responsible. Somebody who is stable, but not predictable. Someone who is very romantic, but doesn't smother me. Somebody who, deep down inside, is decent and nice.
Yeah, and has Mel Gibson's butt.
Two tough guys go back-to-back on NBC. First, it's Hunter, where a psychic prediction could make McCall the next victim of a serial murderer.
I'm Fred Dreyer. Join me on the toughest beat in town. Join me on Hunter tonight.
Then, if you want to cut a deal, you've got to do it Jack Shannon's way. Shannon's deal tonight.